Hello guys, welcome back to Tech Doze, and in this video we shall see how to read an image, write an image back to the hard disk and display the image on the screen as well. If you have not yet subscribed to our channel, then please do so in order to watch more such content. So let us get started. First thing we need to do is open Anaconda prompt in the directory where you have saved the code. Okay, so I have created a code named basicoperations.py and I have saved it in our folder desktop and then Tech Doze. Okay, so you need to copy this path and just change the Anaconda to that path. Okay, just paste it and it will change here. And I have only a code and a JPG file, Ronaldo.jpg. Okay, so let us write the code. Import numpy as np and import cv2. We need to import these two packages. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is we need to read the image. img equals to cv2 dot imread. This imread is a function inside the package cv2, and this takes two parameters. First one is the name of the jpg file, which is ronaldo.jpg, and the second one is the type of image. We give 0 for grayscale images, 1 and minus 1 for colored images. So let us first do for the color images. Now the next thing we need to do is we need to show the image. The image has been read and that will be stored in the form of a matrix, 2D matrix in img. If you print it, then you will be able to see it, but we will see the image here. cv2.imshow. imshow is another function inside cv2 package, and this also takes two parameters. The first one is the name of the output window. Let us just name it output. And the second one is our matrix from which it will read the image. So img was our matrix. Okay, the last thing which we need to do is we need to include a wait key. The wait key will ensure that the output is present for sufficient time in order for us to see it. This wait key freezes the output, and whenever we click any key, then the output window disappears. We will see it in some time. And then I will include cv2.destroyAllWindows, and this will make sure that any window, if it is open, then it will also be closed. Okay, so let us just run the code. I will just copy it and we'll write python basicoperations.py. And let me wait for some time, it will give the output. You can see that this was our original image. Okay, oops, yes, this was our original image, and this is the output. And you can see that the output is written on the top left side, which is the window name which we had given in imshow. Okay, so if you just cross it, then the Anaconda prompt will freeze. Okay, so let us just cross it. And you can see that it has frozen and it is not coming out. So you should not cross it, and you should only click a single key on your laptop or your computer. Okay, so I will have to now close the Anaconda here. I will copy the path wherever I was. I will have to close the Anaconda, and then again I will open the Anaconda. Yes, and yes, this is our code. Yes, now we have done two things. We have read the image and we have displayed the image on our screen. Okay, the next thing we need to do is we need to write the image. So what we need to do is cv2.imwrite. This imwrite is another function inside cv2 package. Let us just name the new file as Luka Modric. Okay, which is the second one. You can see that in our picture there were two people, one was Ronaldo and one was Modric. So I will name the output on his name. Okay, now let us save it and I will just run it. Oops, I will have to copy this and then write python. Yes. Oh, something is missing. It says okay. The second thing is missing. The second level which we want is the matrix. Okay, we need to see the matrix, the image matrix. It will take two parameters, and now we can run it. Now this error is coming. Okay, it says in line number 6. So in line number 6 I have img instead of jpg, so it was coming, and I will just save it. Okay, and again run the code. Now you can see that a colored output is produced, and you can see that there are two colored outputs. One was Ronaldo from our earlier part, and we wrote Luka Modric. Okay, so I will just click a key and it is done. Now let us do it for the gray images. I will just put 0 instead of 1, and it will take the gray image. It will convert the image into the gray image, and will convert it into matrix and store it in img. And whenever we use img, it will always denote the gray image of the ronaldo.jpg file. Okay, so let us just rename it to gray, and I will run it. You can see that this is the gray image. Okay, let us quit, and you can see that there are three images now. One was original image ronaldo.jpg, another one was a colored file which we had created, and now we created the gray image. Okay, so these are the three operations which we are talking about. I hope this video was helpful. If it was helpful, then please hit the like button, and please subscribe to our channel for more OpenCV videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.